is one of the most loved and watched sports around the world. You cheer when your team wins, and you cry when your team loses. But have you ever wondered what it's like to be a professional soccer player and to win titles? I mean, the emotional barriers they must face, like being mentally prepared for a game, or clearing their thoughts of everything but the game. Or the physical challenges they must face, like being physically prepared for a game, or training for a championship game. All these things take a toll on the players. So throughout this documentary, we're going to be focusing on the rookie career of new soccer player Jude Sutton. Hope you enjoy.
Oh my god!
I looked over your stats. Your shot is great. I think you will be a great addition to our team. There is room for improvement. The pay is great, and I think you'll enjoy it. On our team, you'll work hard and get lots of playing time.
Well, Mr. Patel, all my life I've wanted to go pro. So I think with the necessary coaching and experience, I think that I would like to join your team because I've been considering this opportunity for a very long time. So, Mr. Patel, you've got yourself a deal.
Dude, can I have a few moments if you have some questions to ask you?
Ask away.
When you signed the contract with Mr. Patel's team, what was going through your mind?
Well, I was thinking about all the past family members and teammates that helped me to get, you know, to this position where I am today. And I was also thinking about all, like, the training and all the challenges I went through to get to this spot that I am now. I was also very excited. And I was thinking about how much of a big opportunity for this is for me, because this puts us in championship perspective and, you know, it gets us in a really good position. So I thought, if I'm going to start playing hard and playing more serious, this is a great opportunity.
Hey, that's good. So on to the next question. What are some factors that made that went through your mind that you decided to go into this team?
Well, one of the big things is the fact that this team is a championship winning team, and of course I always like to be on the winning team. Another reason is the coach, Mr. Patel. He's a great coach. From training with him just once, I learned that there's so much more that I haven't learned that I can learn from him. And another thing I learned that put me in the spot to join his team was when I played with his team, like when I trained, before signing to see if I'd like his team, I really, really, really like the people on that team. They're very supportive. They're very encouraging. I thought that'd be perfect for a new soccer player trying.
Thank you. Wow, that's great. Thank you.
Thank you.
All you need to do is you just want to want it. It comes from the heart. So to make your shot better, you're going to want to follow through the ball. So you get, that's how you get more power and it goes straight instead of lobbing it. And then also what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to look at where you want to hit it so you get more accuracy.
Okay, that was some good advice, Coach. But what do I want to do when I'm running and make sure I have a good foot placement when the ball's moving?
If it's a slow one, you can take more time on it. But if it's fast, you really want to plant your foot right next to it. And you just have to follow through with it, and you'll automatically get air and distance.
Okay, thank you.
So to get your leg working, gain 5 seconds inside, run all the way and back 10 times.
Walked off the pitch and he seems a little bit frustrated. Let's see what happened during practice.
Who's that?
Ugh. Well, I was over there training, and then my coach came over and he made me do like lots of drills and stuff because I thought You know, it's good for our first game. Why was Coach making you do suicides?
Well, he thought that in order to get my legs worked out, you know, and, you know, stretched out, to get my legs working before the game, he thought I should do suicides. He saw my shot, he gave me some advice, and, you know, being the coach he is, he's gave me running.
And also, you're talking about being physically prepared. Why was those suicides, what was the connection between being physically prepared and the suicides?
Well, you know, players can't go into a game being unprepared physically, like not training before a game, not stretching. Those are all important physical factors that go into training. So, you know, then again, suicides is a way to, you know, build up my endurance so I can be physically ready for however long or however much I have to run during the game.
Well, thanks, Drew. That was some great insight.
Mbe.
This is a dramatic moment. Drew needs to score this to win the game. Ooh, the France losers just fell to 3-2.
So Jude, how do you feel about that this loss may jeopardize your playoff appearance?
Well, I definitely do not like the situation that we are in. But you see, I think that, you know, if I put in like the necessary work and, you know, effort, we could probably have, you know, a really good chance of making it through. So I'm not really that worried.
Shoot, I know you have it in you, so go on and win us this game.
Okay, yes, coach, I'll try my best.
Okay, let's do this.
Yeah! Go, team!
In high-intensity games like these, the pressure on the players is very high. For example, they find it very hard to control themselves and calm down and think about the game. So, I heard from many soccer players that when they lose these big games, such as playoff games or championship games, they find it very deteriorating to their self-esteem. So, the players, they need to find a way to calm themselves down. But I'm Jude, Documentary Man.
Come on, Jude, it's a scoreless half, and we only need one goal. Let's do this.
I mean, yeah, even though it's a scoreless half, I think we can take the game in the second half.
Oh, right, let's go do this. Knuckles.
Jude was just fouled. They have a spot in the playoffs. No. No.
Hello, I am Jack McCacker.
And hi, I'm Dexter's Fulmite host.
And we are Birmingham Breaking News.
Recently on the news, new rookie Drew Sutton has just brought the local team to the championship match.
Also recently on the news, Jack Stanton missed the basket once again. We will see you next time on Birmingham Breaking News.
Thank you. Keep watching.
It's a very short broadcast.
Drew just brought his team to a championship.
How do you feel about bringing your team to a national championship in your first year?
Well, you know, I feel great. I think I definitely filled my expectations for the team and for the fans, definitely. Because sometimes you might feel your expectations, but you won't feel the fans' expectations. But it's great this time because, you know, made the fans happy. And, I don't know, like, what our team to our, what, like, fifth championship or something?
Yeah, that's their fifth championship.
So, it feels great to win, finally. And considering that's my first year with Mr. Patel's team, feels good.
So what are some goals for next year?
Next year, you know, I think it'd be great next year to bring my team to another championship. And, you know, definitely, for someone that's a rookie, like I was this year, you know, I feel like they have a lot of talent. You know, I should take them under my arm and make sure that they, you know, get acquainted with the team and make sure that, you know, they train and kind of be a mentor to them. You know, that'd be great considering all the help I got from the team this year, which took a big part in me winning and scoring.
So that's great. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.